剑桥分析窃取将近9000万脸书用户资料一事闹得沸沸扬扬。脸书创办人扎克伯格星期二在美国华盛顿接受美国国会能源和商业委员会盘问时，被询及为何脸书在2015年发现剑桥分析窃取资料之后没有及时禁止对方的恶行，他说这是脸书公司犯下的大错。
So this is clearly one of the questions that I asked our team as soon as I learned about this is why did we wait until we found out about the reports last month to ban them? It's because as of the time that we learned about their activity in 2015, they weren't an advertiser, they weren't running pages, so we actually had nothing to ban.
他补充，当时剑桥分析告诉脸书，他们没有滥用窃取的资料，而且全都已经删除，因此脸书认为事情已经了结，没想到却被剑桥分析摆了一道。为了避免剑桥分析胡作非为，脸书已经有一套应对方案。
One of the steps that we need to take now is go do a full audit of all of Cambridge Analytica's systems to understand what they're doing, whether they still have any data.To make sure that they remove all the data. If they don't, we're going to take legal action against them to do so. That audit, we have temporarily ceded that in order to let the UK government complete their government investigation first, because of course a government investigation takes precedence over a company doing that. But we are committed to completing this full audit and getting to the bottom of what's going on here.So that way we can have more answers to this.
他强调，2016年美国总统选举之前，脸书已经意识到有很多骇客不断尝试入侵系统，窃取用户资料，尤其是来自俄罗斯的骇客。因此，脸书研发了更精密的系统来保护用户的隐私。目前也积极研发更高端的 AI 系统，鉴定脸书假账号，避免有心人透过假账号窃取资料以及散播假消息误导用户。值得一提的是。这一项功能在总统大选之后成功监测到470个假账号，上个星期也在俄罗斯监测到270个假账号。虽然更高端的安保需要耗费好几年的时间，不过扎克伯格表示，脸书公司在今年底会有超过20000名员工，专门负责安保和用户隐私，确保不再发生类似事件。